During the Prohibition, beginning in the 1920s, conflict arose in America due to the fact that the 18th Amendment was ratified, which caused alcohol to be illegal, defiant activity to break out, and the political atmosphere to shift. Because America's problems were at an all-time high, Congress compromised to repeal the Prohibition Act and then ratify the 21st Amendment.
Prohibition in America was known as the ban of production, importation, transportation, sale, and consumption of alcohol in the early 20th century. The concept of prohibition first arose in Maine. In 1846, Maine was the first state to pass a prohibition law. By the time the Civil War began in 1861, many other states had petitioned to pass that same law. As the 20th century began, the progressive era did as well. Progressivism pushed for many reforms in society that affected every aspect of life and every class of people. The people that backed this movement strived for women's rights, racial equality, alcohol to become illegal, and monopolies to cease to exist. Progressivism was widely supported, which caused many of their goals to be achieved. Through this movement, the Anti-Saloon League was formed. With the combination of the League, evangelical Protestantism, with its members viewing drinking as ungodly, and factory owners wanting to prevent accidents from alcohol consumption, the prohibition was supported by many and a popular belief at that time. In 1917, the United States entered into World War I. In an attempt to save grain for food, President Woodrow Wilson set in motion what was supposed to be only a temporary prohibition of alcohol. However, within that year, Congress had submitted the 18th Amendment for state ratification. This amendment banned all manufacture, transportation, or sale of alcohol in the United States. Congress gave the states a 7-year period to finish the deciding process, but within 11 months, 3/4 of the states had already voted yes for ratification. On January 19, 1919, the 18th Amendment was ratified and went into effect about a year later. That October, Congress passed the National Prohibition Act, otherwise known as the Volstead Act, because a representative of Mississippi and chairman of the House Judiciary Committee, Andrew Volstead, created it. This act set standards and guidelines for the federal enforcement of prohibition. By that time, however, around 33 states had already instituted their own prohibition legislation before enforcement of the amendment. Even though many people supported the prohibition, it was hard for federal and local government to enforce it on the people. Originally, the enforcement of this act was in the hands of the Internal Revenue System, but then was transferred over to the Justice Department. Initially, enforcement of the Prohibition Act was very strict and alcohol consumption rates went down by over 30%, and much fewer people were arrested for drunkenness. For the most part, smaller rural areas enforced the act more than it was enforced in heavily populated urban areas. The reasoning behind this was because it was much harder to control large groups of people rather than smaller ones. Because of this, civilians who wished to continue drinking found alternative, illegal ways to do so. Bootlegging, a term referring to the illegal manufacturing and selling of alcohol, became very popular. Because of bootlegging, criminal activity and gang violence increased as well. An example of someone who thrived during the Prohibition because of his illegal activity was Al Capone. He was a Chicago gangster who gained over $60 million a year from bootlegging and running speakeasies. Such illegal activity attracted violent men together to form gangs. In Chicago, Illinois, in 1929, the St. Valentine's Day Massacre took place. A group of Al Capone's gang members dressed up as police officers and attacked and killed a rival gang. At this time in United States history, gang violence was at an all-time high. Speakeasies, which were secret stores and nightclubs hidden in buildings of underground rooms that sold alcohol, also became common during this time. Many people started to smuggle alcohol across state lines, and some even made liquor themselves. Homemade alcohol was known as moonshine and bathtub gin.
To have a better inside look on what Prohibition was like firsthand, I interviewed my grandma about what it was like for her mother, Alice Marie Lyle, during that time. My great-grandma was in her 20s when she lived in Butte, Montana, during the Prohibition. At this time, Butte was heavily populated and had a lot of different ethnic groups that were very against the Prohibition. Butte was filled with speakeasies all over town. My great-grandma and all of her sisters and friends would always go to the speakeasies in the Italian section of town called Meaderville because they were more of a nightclub than a bar. They had music, food, dancing, and liquor rather than just a common bar. Most of the liquor was locally made. Some families, including hers, were able to make gin in their bathtub. but some of it was also imported from Canada. Her father was a lawyer for the city, yet he always kept alcohol in their house. This shows that even law-abiding citizens could still acquire it with little issues. She said the prohibition in Butte stopped little to no one from consuming alcohol or obtaining it. Because it was in such high demand, bootlegged liquor was more expensive. Therefore, mainly upper class and wealthy people could afford it. This means the working class and the poor were less likely to obtain illegal alcohol. By the 1930s, support for the prohibition was dwindling because the cost for jails and law enforcement were increasing. Because of the prohibition, many people lost their jobs.
The Great Depression struck in 1932. The loss of even more jobs was detrimental. By repealing the act, the liquor industry rebooting would create jobs for all the people in the Depression. Franklin D. Roosevelt had run for president that year with the idea to repeal the Prohibition Act and the 18th Amendment. With this idea, he won by a landslide. In February of 1933, Congress came up with a compromise. They decided to submit a 21st Amendment that had repealed the 18th for the states to vote on, just like they had done for the 18th Amendment. That December, the state of Utah was the 36th and final vote necessary for the 21st Amendment to be ratified. Some states tried to continue prohibition of alcohol even after the act was repealed, but by 1966, all traces of prohibition were gone.